Hey everyone, my name is Daniel and welcome back to another video. I hope all of you are having a great day out there. As always, here today, we need to talk about Voyager Digital, but more specifically, dive in deep into a big piece of news that we just got from Steve Ehrlich on Twitter pertaining to a potential partnership with one of the biggest names in the food industry. In this video, we got to talk about exactly what's going on here, the potential implications this has for Voyager as a company, platform, stock, and cryptocurrency, and exactly what I'm doing in response to this moving forward. So if you end up enjoying this video and potentially finding some value in it, please consider subscribing. And without further ado, let's get into the video. So first and foremost here, we have to understand that Voyager Digital, they are a publicly traded cryptocurrency brokerage that offer upwards of 60 digital assets to buy or sell on their platform commission free. You can also earn interest on a majority of the holdings that they offer. But beyond that, beyond being a cryptocurrency brokerage, Voyager has plans to expand into becoming more of a lifestyle financial app over the long run, with plans to expand into stock trading, debit cards, credit cards, person-to-person money and crypto sending, and a variety of other ventures. And one of these ventures that they plan on expanding into in the near future is crypto-based payments. Payment processing using cryptos as a form of currency. And a couple of months ago, we got a partnership with Lottery.com and Voyager to launch crypto-based payments on the Lottery.com platform to be able to buy lottery tickets or potentially participate in some of their games using Bitcoin, Ethereum, USDC stablecoins as a form of payment. And this is obviously in partnership with Voyager Digital. So payment processing, this is a big opportunity for Voyager as a platform to, again, expand into much more than just being a cryptocurrency brokerage. And what we've got here today is some big potential news that has the potential to really expand Voyager's opportunity in the payment processing space. And here is exactly what I am talking about. So this is the conversation that we got here on Twitter. And the person we're talking about is Robert Irvine. And this is, we'll talk about him in a moment here, but he is one of the big names in the food space. He has a lot of television shows, and I want to say one of them is very, very similar to a Gordon Ramsay-esque style show called Kitchen Nightmares, where he goes in and tries to kind of fix restaurants, right? And he's got a big following with over 400,000 followers on Twitter. This is, no one to just look over. This is a guy with a lot of fans and someone very popular in the food space, one of the biggest names out there. And what we had here today, this is just, Robert tweeting like normal. He kind of just responded sarcastically, at least in my opinion. Someone says, "I really don't stand or don't stand you, but I wanted to watch your show." He said, "Susan, I'm sorry you feel that way. May I ask why you can't stand me?" And Steve responded to this: "I like watching your shows. Keep them coming. Now, if we can get crypto payments into the restaurants, that would be amazing at Invest Voyager, VGX token, and Voyager Digital stock." Now, little do we know that after this, we get a response from Robert saying, "Hey, now that's something you have to figure out." Now that's something you have to figure out. Okay, he misspelled that. But either way, I'm all in. This is big. Steve responds with, "Done. Give me a few weeks and we make it happen." This is huge. Before we move on to this kind of next part of this thread here, from more information from Robert, I want to go through exactly how big this is. When we talk about companies like Square or potentially Stripe, these are multi-hundred billion dollar companies. Stripe in the private markets valued anywhere from around $50 to $100 billion in market cap. Square, again, a very large company that their revenues are based pretty much entirely off of payment processing, not as much in the crypto space, but mainly through, retailers, payment processing through potentially e-commerce, retail locations, but it's payment processing. So as we know, the opportunity in payment processing is huge. So when we talk about Voyager Digital expanding into payment processing with a bit of a cryptocurrency spin to it, sure, the potential might not be there for them to meet Stripe with revenue and valuation, but at the end of the day, we know the market for this is huge, and there are not many companies out there doing things similar to Voyager in the sense of potential payment processing. So to see Robert Irvine come out and be in support of payment processing within, his entire space, whether it be his restaurants or the restaurants that he works with, or potentially publicity through his show, this is something very big and opens up a huge opportunity for Voyager over the long run. Now, this is the next thing that absolutely shocked me here. As right now, sure, he said that, maybe he forgets about it in a couple weeks, but that's kind of my original thought. But this gives me a lot of certainty, and I hope it does give you certainty as well. After he says, you know, now that's something you have to figure out, I'm all in. This individual here, you know, he is a VGX hero. If you're not interested or kind of familiar with that program, it's people involved with Voyager and the VGX token, supporters of it. But soon, Robert Irvine, looking forward to spending my crypto on the Voyager platform using their soon released debit card. Have you bought crypto on the Voyager platform yet? Question. Steve is a great guy to talk to on the subject and is building an amazing ecosystem. So from my understanding, this individual, he goes out and is trying to familiarize, at least Robert in this situation, with Voyager as a platform. And this right here gives me so much conviction that this partnership is not just speculation, but in reality will come to fruition over the coming weeks. Look at this response. Where is it? Here. Yes. And Steve and I are friends, and I am an investor. Great things to come from Steve Ehrlich. This is huge, guys. He is confirming that he knows Steve personally, that he potentially uses, at least from my understanding, he uses the Voyager platform or potentially is an investor in their stock. More likely the kind of the first situation there where he is a user of the Voyager platform, saying that great things are to come from Steve Ehrlich, essentially confirming that there will be some form of partnership between Robert and Steve, or, you know, Robert's different shows over potentially the coming months here, which opens up a huge opportunity for Voyager as a company to not just expand on payment processing, but potentially expand their advertising campaign. As we know, Voyager is getting heavily involved, or at least over the next couple of weeks, months, more heavily involved in actual marketing, whether that be on TV, influencers. Robert Irvine is, you know, another potential target for partnerships and market, kind of a marketing campaign over the coming months. So, you know, whatever happens here, if it's just payment processing, either way, big chance is talked about on the show. If it's, you know, potentially payment processing plus some form of marketing, that's a great thing. Either way, this is a flat out positive for Voyager Digital. And either way, it's a situation where Voyager continues to execute and Steve is finding ways to expand the Voyager platform and familiarize people with Voyager as a platform alongside that. So I'm very optimistic around this whole situation. And you know, let me know in the comment section down below what your thoughts are on this whole situation. There's a ton of optimism around Voyager right now. I mean, not just Voyager kind of expanding as a company, expanding into different verticals, expanding their user base, but on top of that, we see continued rebounds in cryptocurrency prices across the board, with Bitcoin now sitting at over $34,280, leading to, again, we've talked about this many times in the past. If you are a shareholder of Voyager Digital stock, it really is a situation where, you know, as Bitcoin decreases in price, you generally see a decrease in crypto trading volume across the board, as decreased sentiment leads to decrease in trading volume. But this kind of increase in price that we have seen over the past couple of days is leading to a lot of optimism that potentially we're going to see some form of a rebound here over the next couple of months. I mean, it was just a couple of days ago that Bitcoin was under $30,000. Now we're sitting at $34,000, upwards of potentially hitting $35,000 over the next couple of days here. I'm very optimistic, and I just want to finish it off by taking a look at, you know, this is a buddy of mine. We do the VGX or Voyager Roundtable twice a month, and this is actually very interesting here. He points out to the fact that, I think my face is covering his actual tweet, take a look at what's happened the last four times that Bitcoin price bounced when the fear index hits 10. So, you know, the fear index, RSI potentially, shows when, you know, there's a lot of pessimism around the cryptocurrency and Bitcoin sector, and, you know, we can see it. February of 2018, right after we had that crash. December of 2018. September of 2019. Those were times where, again, we saw continued deep stagnation and declines in the prices of cryptocurrencies. March 20th. I mean, everything was going down back then. Now, we've hit it again. And looking forwards here, we're seeing a rebound. I don't know what may happen moving forwards here, but I'm seeing a lot of optimism around Voyager and a lot of potential for them to, you know, really grow as a company over the coming months here, with a potential great climate, great management team, and great company alongside that. So anyways, thank you all so much for watching this video. If you found some value in it, please consider subscribing. And also let me know in the comment section down below if what your thoughts were on that potential live stream that I made just a couple of hours ago. If you haven't watched it yet, I'll leave it linked in the description down below. I go through Voyager, we answer some Q&A, valuation stuff, a lot of interesting things. So anyways, thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye.